In this lecture, I will explain you about interfacing a microprocessor to keyboard. Here, keyboard is one of the major input blocks for any microcomputer. Here, I considered a hexadecimal type keyboard. Means we also call this one as 4x4 keyboard. This hexadecimal keyboard implies that it consists of 16 number of keys as shown here. The keys are shown here from 0, 1, 2, 3, so on, F. So, totally it consists of 16 number of keys. Here, these keys are mechanical type push buttons. Here, these keys are connected in a row wise, in 4 rows, column wise, in 4 columns. These columns are connected to plus 5 volts power supply via considering 10 kilowatt resistor as shown here and here. Here, when we press these keys, the switch can be closed here. Here, these switches are connected at the cross section at each point here as shown in this configuration. Here, the rows are connected to the port A of 8255 programmable peripheral interface to the lines PA0, PA1, PA2 and PA3. The columns are connected to the port P of programmable peripheral interface by considering 8 number of lines from PB0 to PB7. PB4 to PB7 are directly connected from the column side, and PB0 to PB3 are connected from the port A lines. That means here the diode anode side we considered the connection. Here the connection is only indicates by the stick dots. Here I considered the black dots are showing the connection of each switch. We already know the address locations of 8255 programmable peripheral interface for port A, FCH. Here we are considering port A as output port. And port B, the address location is going to be FBH. H is nothing but indicating hexadecimal number. Here we are considering port B as input port. And we have to find out the status data of control word register. And the address location of control word register is going to be FFH. These address locations are we already discussed in the 8255 programmable peripheral interface. Now we have to find out the data of control word register. Here, these data we are going to find out by considering the bits D0 to D7. We already know the each bit specification. Here D7 bit indicate we are going to use a input output mode or BSR mode. But in this configuration we are using input output mode. So this bit is going to be 1. This is the important one. And coming to the first bit, D0 bit will indicate the port C lower. Port C lower bit means in this configuration we are not going to use port C. So simply I am placing a 0 bit here. Next, move to the D1 bit. D1 bit will indicate the port B. Port B. So here we are using port B as input port. So this bit is going to be 1. Next, D2 bit will indicate the mode selection. Here we are going to use port B in mode 0. So this bit is going to be 0. Next, moving to the next bit, D3. D3 bit will indicate port C lower. So here we are not going to use port C. So this value is also 0. Next bit, D4 bit, that is indicate the port A. Here we are using port A as output port in mode 0. So this one also important. So this is important bit, this is important bit. Next 2 bits, the D6 and D5 bits are indicating the mode of selection. So here mode selection is going to be mode 0. So these two bits will become 0 and 0. Finally, we may write the hexadecimal number by considering 4 bits. 1, 0, 0, 0. It is going to be 8. Next to 4 bits, 0, 0, 1, 0. Nothing but 2. So the status data of control word register is going to be 82H. Some important points of interfacing a microprocessor to keyboard of this configuration. Here, the first important point is, if we consider any keyboard, the key switches are connected as matrix of rows and columns. Next one, a keyboard is used for a transfer of a key data. It has to perform the following task. These three are the major important tasks when we are pressing a key switch. Here, the first important task is to detect the key press. Second one, to release the key, that is, to debounce the key. The third one is, encode the key press, means, produce a standard code for pressed key. When no keys are pressed, the column lines are will be high as they are connected to plus 5 volts. We already explained it before here. Next one, when a key is pressed, it connects both rows and columns. Hence, a low voltage is produced on the corresponding row and column, thereby helping in identifying the key. Coming to the explanation of this configuration of a keyboard interfacing, this is the table we are using here. When a key is pressed like 0, 1, 2, so on, F, we are going to use the input port, port B. The port B lines are going to be PB0 to PB7 and the respective hexadecimal code is going to be right here. Here we are using port B as input port, means here all the column lines are going to be 1, only the line is going to be 0 when the key is going to be pressed there. Suppose if a 0 key is pressed, means if a 0 key is pressed here, this switch is connected with the lines only with the PB4 as shown here and the PB3 as shown here. So PB3 and PB4 lines are going to be at low voltage, means PB3, PB4 lines are going to be 0, 0. Remaining other lines are going to contain the value 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. The respective hexadecimal code is going to be 1, 1, 1, 0, means we know that E. 0, 1, 1, 1 means we know that 7. Coming to the next key, if we press 1 on this keyboard, this 1 is connected at the cross section of the lines with the PB5 port B and the PB3 as shown here. This line is common to all the 4 switches from 0, 1, 2, 3. So PB3 line is going to be 0 and PB5 line is going to be 0. Remaining other lines are 1. The hexadecimal code is going to be E1011, means B. Now if we press the key 2, this is the regarding data we are going to face and that corresponding hexadecimal bit is going to be E and D. And if we press 3, the hexadecimal data is we find that E. And coming to the last key, if we press E, the E switch is going to be connected with the lines of here P, PB6, here this one, and this line is connected with the PB0 as shown in this configuration. If we press the key E, this switch is going to be connected with the TB6 here and TB0 here. These lines values going to be 0 here, 0 here. The remaining other lines are going to contain 1 here. So TB0 is going to be 0 and TB6 is going to be, this is 1, TB6 is going to be 0, TB7 is going to be 1. The hexadecimal data is going to be 7D. If you press the key F as shown in this configuration, this switch F is connected with the lines TB7 and the PA. TB0 is common in the before. Totally this line, this row is connected with the TB0. The second one, 8th switch, 9th switch, A switch, B switch is connected with the TB1 line. So coming to the switch F, 0 is here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1, 1, 1 here, 0 here. The hexadecimal data is going to be 7 and E. This completes the explanation of interfacing a microprocessor to the keyboard.